water. We need the river. We need Ezekiel 47. We need the river of God. We need the river of God to come up off the banks, Mike, come after us and overtake us with waters that we can swim in. We can't get away from them. We need an Ezekiel 47 move. We need to come into agreement, this thing called agreement. Where is the agreement? What did you promise God? What did you agree to do? When he called you and he spoke those words over you and anointed you and filled you with the Holy Spirit, he hasn't changed. We have changed. He is the same. We are different. We're sitting there in complacency, complaining about our circumstances at times when we can get up, call some Christians, have them come over and break those conditions. And we can get people to come into our homes, our businesses, legitimate caring people, not people that want to make a buck off of you, but people that care about you, that will come in and pray and bring a change. I decree change over this church. I decree, God, the destiny that you have for this church will not falter. It will not fail. It will not fall. I decree and I declare, I ask for the voices to rise up. Yes. True voices of God. Yes. What do you got to lose? You have everything to gain by having such a move of the Holy Spirit that it'll be unparalleled in the lives of the people and it'll shake them to their very being, but they will wake up and come alive, and the Lord says there'll be an agreement and a power and authority you've dreamed about for years. The Lord says, arise up, O sleeper, and come out of your slumber, says the Lord. It's not just for this church, it's for the church of Jesus Christ. You got to get mad at yourself. You got to say, I've had enough of me. I've had enough of lethargy. I've had enough of waiting in this waiting pattern. I've had enough of this boredom. I've had enough. I have it up to here. There's no more place for it to go. We have got to clean up our houses. We've got to make changes. We've got to get a direction in the direction of the Lord. We have got to wake up. We've got to change. And we've got to say, Lord, I'm ready for you to anoint me for the new day. I don't know why the Lord just told me third day. I don't know that much about that. There's been so much playing games with the anointing and the prophetic. That's kind of what I know about, okay? Playing games. People have gotten words that haven't come to pass yet. Or they've been sold a bill of goods, told things, and it hasn't happened, so you're mad. But what hasn't happened? You're not famous and you're mad. You don't have a fortune, so you're mad. You want to be popular. You want to be known. You want to be special. You want to be the special ones. No, you're the servant to everyone. You're to serve. You're to minister. You know, this wanting to be popular and make a fortune and have fame and all these things. I have so many friends that are running towards that. It'll profit us nothing. Now, my pastor said to me Sunday, and he warned me. He said, stick to what you're called to do no matter what it looks like. Because God's going to have a breakthrough for you. Look around. A lot of people aren't here tonight. They weren't here 2 weeks ago. So the enemy would love me to give up on it. But I say there's about to be a breakthrough because the Lord said so. Mm-hmm. He said, my pastor, be faithful. Not just with Larkspur, but Colorado Springs, with everything I'm doing. Be faithful. Because when you're faithful with the small, God will can trust you with a greater work. Now, why do I want a greater work? What's my motive? What is my need? What's your need out there? Why do you want to minister? What's your agenda? Do you have an agenda? And what is it? God knows I'd do this every night of the week if I was asked. God knows that's the truth. But there's still something in me that's wondering, where are the people? Why aren't they coming to the meetings? What's happened? Why does it look like things are drying up? That's God's business. Let it dry up. I can't worry about it. I can't be afraid of it. And I can't stop what I'm called to do because it looks like there's a drought, a spiritual drought. I'm telling you, the rain's coming. I'm telling you, there might be a few little drops, but the rain's coming. Deluge, is that the word? Of rain. The former and the latter rain together, coming together. I'm telling you, Mike, the river's rising. I'm telling you, the things that God has spoken to us are true. He has not lied. He has a call on our life. All we want to know is, Lord, is this what you want us to do? Bless it. Is there a blessing on it? What is the blessing? Is the blessing contained in a room full of people that's packed? Or is the blessing in the anointing? And that lives are helped, individual people that come in and their lives are touched. We get email, Armin gets email all the time, praise reports all the time. I've been lackadaisical to put them on my, give them today for the website. I've been lackadaisical to, you know, put on my website or email what I'm going to speak about. I told the girls over here when we were praying before the meeting started, I said, I've just kind of been in this slump. But I've got to get up. I've got to get the word out. I want to see people's lives changed. So that word from Dina and Mike tonight was very touching for me. Because if people are out there saying, what about when we used to? You know, when we used to. But I have another thing to say. You won't come to where the anointing is. You won't attend meetings of people that don't have a big name where there's an anointing, a power, an authority flowing. No, you have to go to the Hollywood Christianity groups where you think they're famous and there's fortune and there's something for you there, like as if they're going to promote you. I got news for you. You will not be promoted because promotion comes from God and God alone. I say get to where the anointing is. Get to where there's moves of God. Get to where you can hear, that you can see, you can taste his presence. Things are changing. You've got to be where the anointing is. You cannot afford to stay in situations and places where it's dead and dry. Like in Ezekiel 37, can these dry bones live, said the Lord, prophesy to these dry bones and say to these dry bones, thus saith the Lord, dry bones, call for the breath of the Spirit to come and enter into the dead, dry bones. That tells me that there needs to be a breath of God. That tells me that the breath of God needs to be blowing on the people with a refreshing, reviving, calling them back to life. I pray with my whole heart tonight that if you are in that condition, if we as the body of Christ are in that condition where we have dead, dry bones, I don't care if it's one bone in you. I don't care if it's your whole body. I don't care if it's the corporate body of Jesus Christ. We need to prophesy into those dead, dry places. Do you have dead, dry places? Everybody does. If we're honest, we admit that. That there are areas in our life that are dead and dry and we don't seem to know what to do. Because we're not speaking the word over ourselves. We're not speaking the word over our friends. We're not speaking the word of God over our families. We might do it once or twice. Then we get lackadaisical and we forget. We need to start speaking. We need to start putting scriptures up on our refrigerators. And ladies, where you put your makeup on. And men, where you brush your teeth and shave. A scripture that means something to you. And begin to speak it out. And begin to cry out to the Lord for change. God is shifting this church. He just said it to me right now. He is shifting it. There's a shift. Not only coming, but it's here, says the Lord. And when he does a shift, things change. Things have to be rearranged. There's a new focus that comes in. God begins to speak some powerful things. And then we've got to do this thing that we all seem to dread. We got to move by faith. We got to move by faith. And then faith comes in to make the movement of the power of God come forth. Because faith comes by what? Hearing. And by the word of God.